Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin, Brett Summers, Gary Burghoff, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, and Patti Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Body Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
What's wrong? Everything okay?
Okay. We greet you. Don't overdo it. You get your check anyway.
Oh, okay.
Now, for those of the benefit of you in the studio audience and you who are watching maybe for the first time, have a little tradition. The celebrities always give a nice, warm greeting to the new kid on the block, and we welcome Dick Martin.
Yeah!
How are you?
Just fine, Gene.
We're delighted to have you here.
You have a delightful show.
Thank you very much.
Have you ever seen it?
Yes. I wouldn't miss it.
Good for you.
Come on down.
He wouldn't miss it.
Okay, now let's say hello to our two players here, Evie Phineas and Susan Copperthwaite.
Yeah.
Evie is our current champ. She's won one game, and she has $600 to her credit. And let's see, how many days have you been on now, Evie? I've forgotten. What is this, your third or fourth? Or second? Third.
Speak up, Evie!
This is your second day. Oh, well, you're a veteran.
No, it's...
Third.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Well, you're a veteran by now. It's his old hat, isn't it? Nothing to it, right?
Right.
Talkative rascal, isn't she? Now, she's going to be challenged by Susan Copperthwaite, who will tell us a little bit about herself, if you would, please.
Okay, I'm married. I live in Simi Valley. I have two sons, and I enjoy needlepoint and growing plants, painting statuary, and I think you're terrific.
Thank you. Well, that's one for me. Mine. I do needlepoint, too.
Do you really?
Yes.
Isn't it fun?
Oh, needlepoint is marvelous therapy, yes. You see what it did for me? Now, we'll start this game in a moment or so, but first we got this message for you. Here we go. Now, here we go. I will push this button, ladies, and reveal our two first-round questions. Ask Susan to make a selection.
I'll take B, please.
B it is. Here we go. Everybody plays new game, folks. Albert said...
Uh-huh.
I found the solution to the energy crisis, but it only works in Washington, D.C. I've invented an automobile that runs on blank. I found the solution. Think about that, Susan. I found a solution to the energy crisis. It only works in Washington, D.C. I've invented an automobile that runs on blank.
You know.
Oh, I got it. I got it, honey.
Yes,
you use it all the time.
Right. Look, he was the first one. All right, here we go.
He's smart, isn't he?
Call on Susan. Albert said. I found the solution to the energy crisis, but it only works in Washington, D.C. I've invented an automobile that runs on blank.
Tapes.
On what?
Tapes.
On tapes. Did you hear what she said? She says...
That's funny.
But there's an 18-minute gap between Los Angeles and San Francisco.
That's right. Car only goes for 18 minutes. Huh?
Yes.
She said tapes. Dick, what did you say?
Well, I'm afraid I said something a little more prosaic. Hot air.
Hot air. And we're not kidding, senators. Brett, what do you say?
You know what I say?
Well,
let you and me get married.
You did it!
Hot air!
Hot air! Now, if you also said hot air, you got to think of something clever to say like they did before you say hot air and hold up your card, don't you?
I had something very clever, but it's too late now. You blew it for me. Hot air.
Hot air, okay. Hot air seems to have been the answer, Susan, although your answer of tapes is rather interesting. What do you say, madam?
I am so worried. I'm thinking like Brett now.
Really?
I said hot air.
Hot air. That's four orders of hot air. And now we come to Richard.
Tapes is a marvelous answer.
Yes, we'll say.
No, really, because it, you know, would not only get you where you're going, it would lie about the mileage. to hear all those politicians speak, and I know the car would run on bull manure.
Listen, you may think he's doing jokes, but the fact is I read a long technical article about a guy who makes methane gas out of bull manure, and he ran a car in England, and you can do it out of garbage, out of chicken droppings, out of...
But the exhaust!
Well, the only trouble is when you go for a drive in the country, your car keeps attacking cows.
Oh, that's right.
No, that's enough. Now...
You know, I really didn't see, I didn't see this until this moment. It says Fanny Flagg on your
t-shirt. Of course it does.
That's very cute.
Well, thank you.
How are you, Patti?
I'm just swell.
You gonna play the game with us?
I suppose.
Let the baby play.
Yes. What have you got there?
Well, coming from a sheltered home life and all, I said that it ran on bovine droppings.
Bovine droppings. That girl went to college. Okay, now we got your question, Evie. You ready for this? The warden said, I think that prisoner's been on the chain gang too long. Yesterday, he tried to blank his ball. That's it. Oh, look at me, the warden's saying, what am I? I'm just the middleman here.
Everybody look at the writers.
Yeah. The warden said, are you listening, Evie? The warden said, I think that prisoner's been on the chain gang too long. Yesterday, he tried to blank his ball. Right. Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, Marianne?
Yes, I'm thinking.
Oh, you
yes,
are thinking.
Right.
Okay.
Okay.
Ha, that's Dick, you're very quick. You have a quick mind, don't you?
I don't know whether I don't know whether.
May I just peek there? No. My show. Get your own show if you want to peek at answers there.
No, Dick, you're supposed to write something on the card.
Okay. Yeah. The upper tier is finished. Are you fiddling around? What are you doing, Marianne? What are you? Okay, now she's ready.
It's a disaster anyway.
Evie Phineas will now give us a response. The warden said, I think that prisoner's been on the chain gang too long. Yesterday, he tried to blank his ball.
I'll say kiss. That's all I can think. Where?
Now, hold on just a minute. Evie's a little insecure, so don't boo her. Did you see on yesterday's show or whatever it was? What was yesterday, John? Was yesterday Friday? Look on your sheet there and tell me what... Yesterday was Tuesday. Did you see her on yesterday's show?
Well, this must be Belgium.
Well, anyway, you heard her answer. Dick, what did you say?
I'd love to match hers, but I did say lift.
Tried to lift the football, okay. Brett, what did you say?
Well, I kind of went along with Evie because I'm crazy about her.
She's cute, isn't she?
Cutest thing we've ever had on this show. I said he tried to marry his ball.
Oh.
He was a desperate man. Yeah.
The chain would have been the, yes.
Yes,
you
Gary? Just wanted to know it. Well, he was the guy towards the end with the limp. I said bounce his ball.
Tried to bounce his ball. That was a good answer. Try to pick up that 80 pie. I don't know how much of those things weigh. All right, Marianne, we're up to you.
I wish I could take it all back.
He tried to kiss his ball is what Evie said. Now, what did you say?
Oh, and I like your answer so much better. Well, you know how terrible food is.
Yes. Well, I've never been in prison, but I hear it's pretty bad.
He tried to eat it.
Okay. All right, now.
Is there someone crazy like me in the audience?
That's right. There are a lot of crazy people in the world. What did you say?
And they're all out there.
I'm with Brett. Al Mario.
Tried to marry the ball, yeah.
And they were very happy, actually.
That's right.
Then sort of drifted.
Well, you know, you really had the same idea that Evie had because, you know, the...
Well, I didn't want any hanky-panky.
Right.
Get married first and then do what you like.
Okay, Fanny. Fanny, what do you say?
Well, my prisoner wasn't about to make a lasting commitment, just, you know, one of those things. Yeah. He tried to bed his ball.
Sorry, Evie, you didn't score with that. And as you can plainly see, we got another one of those tight games going here. And we'll continue with all this intense contest in a moment or so, but now this. Round two coming up. Now, ladies, Susan.
Okay.
give B another chance.
You're going to give B another chance, yeah. And vice versa.
You did so well with it.
Yeah, did well with it last time. The funeral director said, uh-huh. I just planned a funeral for the most insecure man I've ever met. He made me promise to bury his blank with him. That's what the funeral director said. Planned a funeral for the most insecure man I've ever met. He made me promise to bury his blank with him.
Oh, honey, I've got it.
Your brow is furrowed.
Oh, honey, it's an easy one.
Gary's first one finished. All right, upper tier is ready. You got it.
He was last.
Did you change your mind? Okay. All right, now we'll call on Susan. The funeral director said, I just planned a funeral for the most insecure man I've ever met. He made me promise to bury his blank with him.
Okay. Teddy bear?
Teddy bear. That'd be good. Yeah. That's a symbol of security, isn't it? Teddy bear is a symbol of security. I did an interview once with the actor Peter Bull. Is that his name?
He has thousands of teddy bears.
He has thousands. And he told me that many men went into war with their little teddy bears.
Well, because that's how we lost the British Empire.
Teddy bear is a security symbol. What did you say, Dick?
I said his wife.
Oh. Bury his wife with him. Well, that'd make you feel secure, wouldn't it?
I don't know who she was, anyway.
What did you say?
Well, honey, it kind of goes along with that, but not completely. He wants to take his little blankie with
his
him.
His security blanket.
Yeah.
Sure. Sure. Security blanket is what she said. What do you say?
What do you think Radar O'Reilly would say? Of course, his teddy bear.
His teddy bear. Now, wait a minute. Didn't I see you in an episode of MASH involving a teddy bear?
Many, many episodes of MASH. You can see me at home involving a teddy bear.
How do you think his wife got pregnant?
That's enough of that. Now,
he spread honey all over the room.
He made me promise to bury his blank with him, and Susan said teddy bear. What do you say, Marianne?
Well, yes, they put his thumb in his mouth and then gave him his teddy bear.
Two for you. Do you offer that lady a teddy bear?
I wish I did. I wrote tapes. I said security blanket.
Security blanket, yeah. I guess that's the answer. Patti, did you have a security blanket as a child?
Yeah, and so did he.
And so did he, all right. So that's two for you. And now, Evie, you have to match two celebrities to stay in the game. Three will win your second game. The electrician said, I have just examined the $6 million man. And... uh-huh. I don't know how to explain it, but he's blank.
What, sweetheart?
Could you repeat that, please?
Evie, are you confused? Well, I'll read it again for Evie's benefit. The electrician said, I have just examined the $6 million man, and I don't know how to explain it, but he's blank. Think about it for a second while they're finishing writing. They haven't even started writing yet.
Is the operative word electrician?
The electrician said, I have just examined the $6 million man, and I don't know how to explain it, but he's blank. I don't know. I can't tell you what the operative word is, because that'd be leading you to an answer. I can only repeat it over and over again. 50 times if I have to.
Endlessly.
She is a little slow, you see.
Huh?
All right, now.
I'm with you. I don't have a clue, Evie.
All right.
I'll answer it anyway.
Put that right in the slot there. There we go. Now, Evie Phineas, the electrician said, don't say no until I've read the question.
Take your time.
Oh, okay. What you're trying to tell us is you've heard it three times, you haven't thought of an answer yet, huh? All right, I'll read it very slowly for you. You have green eyes, don't you? Very pretty.
Thank you.
Yeah. How many kids have you got?
Two.
Oh, how old are your kids?
I know that today.
Yes. Last time she didn't know how old her kids were.
10 and 2.
Good. All right, now the electrician said... I have just examined the $6 million man. Have you heard of him?
Yeah.
You have? Okay. And he said, I don't know how to explain it, but he's blank.
He's blank.
Well, I said that, you see. I said he's blank. You have to say he's...
Why? I can't say that.
Well, now, wait a minute.
Okay.
You want to whisper something to me and I'll tell you?
I don't think I...
Well,
Now, wait a minute. You know what you can say and what you've watched this show a lot. You know what you can say and what you can't say, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
I don't have an answer, so I'll just say, he's what?
Come on, step her. What? Not supposed to do what?
You're supposed to just say it.
Say it.
I forgot the question.
You forgot the question. All right, the question is, the electrician said, I have just examined the $6 million man. And I don't know how to explain it, but he's... He's what?
No.
That's the answer we have to go with because the audience heard it, and I heard it. She said he's sterile. Okay.
That's possible, isn't it?
That's possible. Yeah. Pay $6 million for a man, and...
Would you show us your answer, please?
I'd say it's very close to sterile, really. It's short-circuited.
How about that? Well, I suppose that'd make him sterile. What did you say?
What was it she said?
She said, I don't know how to explain it, but he's sterile.
Good gravy, Marie. What a peculiar answer.
Yes, it is, isn't it?
Well, of course a man full of batteries would be sterile. Oh,
Evie,
I knew she would.
You did. Well, why did you torture me that way? Why didn't you tell me right away?
I think he was scared.
That's right. If we uncover one more sterile man, you will tie the game down. What do you say?
Hmm?
Yes. Are you nervous?
Would you repeat the question?
Yes. I don't know how to explain it, but he's blank.
Sterile!
Well, you pay $6 million for a man and nothing works because he has a short circuit.
Short circuit. Okay. Now.
We're looking for another sterile man.
Her answer is...
It's an old war.
The question is...
I have just examined the $6 million man. I don't know how to explain it, but he's...
AC and DC.
He runs both ways.
I see. Okay. To Fanny Flag.
Yeah. Likewise,
ACDC. High score. Okay, this game ends in a tie, and we'll tell you what happens when we do have a tie right after we tell you about this. Now, here's what happens when we have a tie. You ready, Evie, to break the tie? Okay. We wipe the slate clean, and we push this button and reveal our two tie-breaking questions. One question for each. The one who scored the most will be the winner. Susan?
Take B again.
B again for the third time in a row, eh?
Gotta get right.
The Godfather didn't have any confetti. So when the parade went by, he threw blank out the window. Godfather didn't have any confetti, so when the parade went by, he threw blank out the window. All right. Waiting for the lady with the red hair.
Come on, Pat. Just don't take advantage
and
just
the roots
because you're
to match.
Preggy.
Now. Susan, the Godfather didn't have any confetti, so when the parade went by, he threw blank out the window.
It's gotta be bullets.
He threw bullets.
Bullets.
She says, took a handful of bullets, flung them right out the window. What do you say?
I said he threw his brother out the window.
He threw his brother. Lovely fellow.
Yeah,
you'd be a rascal. What do you say?
Well, he wanted to perk things up.
Yeah.
So he threw several bodies out the
several
window.
Several bodies. I love a parade. What do you say?
I said money.
Money. Okay, Marianne, money. What do you say?
I said bullets.
Bullets. There's one, Susan.
Spaghetti.
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 Spaghetti. So that's one for Susan. And now, Evie. We don't have a question for you now. What we have for you now is a commercial message. Are you ready for it?
Yeah.
All right, watch. I can't move because my mic is busted and it'll make a lot of noise, so I just say goodbye. Goodbye.
Hey, you're Bob Goen, right?
Yeah. Your new game show, what's it called?
That's the question.
That's the answer?
That's the question?
Exactly.
That's the question. The new word game hosted by Bob Goen. Weeknights at 6, 5 Central on GSN.
And I know the car would run on bull manure.
That was incredible. Yeah. Now listen, you may think he's doing jokes, but the fact is I read a long technical article about a guy who makes methane gas out of bull manure, and he ran a car in England, and you can do it out of garbage, out of chicken droppings, out of...
But the exhaust!
Well, the only trouble is when you go for a drive in the country, your car keeps attacking cows.
Oh, that's right.
No.
That's
enough.
Now... You know, I really didn't see, I didn't see this until this moment. It says Fanny Flagg on your t-shirt.
Well, of course it does.
That's very cute.
Yeah, well, thank you.
How are you, Patti?
I'm just swell.
You gonna play the game with us?
I suppose.
Let the baby play.
Yes. What have you got there?
Well, coming from a sheltered home life and all, I said that it ran on bovine droppings.
Bovine droppings. Girl went to college. Okay, now we got your question, Evie. You ready for this? The warden said, I think that prisoner's been on the chain gang too long. Yesterday he tried to blank his ball. That's it. Look at me, the warden's like, what am I? I'm just the middleman here.
Everybody look at the writers.
Yeah. The warden said, are you listening, Evie? The warden said, I think that prisoner's been on the chain gang too long. Yesterday, he tried to blank his ball. Right. Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, Marianne?
Yes, I'm thinking.
Oh, you
yes,
are thinking.
Right.
Okay.
Okay.
Ha, that's
Dick,
a
you're
lot.
Very quick. You have a quick mind, don't you?
I don't know whether... I don't know whether...
May I just peek there? No. It's my show. Get your own show if you want to peek at answers there.
No, Dick, you're supposed to write something on the card.
Okay. The upper tier is finished. Are you fiddling around? What are you doing? Marianne... What are you? Okay, now she's ready.
It's a disaster anyway.
Evie Phineas will now give us a response. The warden said, I think that prisoner's been on the chain gang too long. Yesterday, he tried to blank his ball.
I'll say kiss. That's all I can think. Where?
Now, hold on just a minute. Evie's a little insecure, so don't boo her. Did you see on yesterday's show or whatever it was? What was yesterday, John? Was yesterday Friday? Look on your sheet there and tell me what... Yesterday was Tuesday. Did you see her on yesterday's show?
Well, this must be Belgium.
Well, anyway, you heard her answer. Dick, what did you say?
I love to match hers, but I did say lift.
Tried to lift the football, okay. Brett, what did you say?
Well, I kind of went along with Evie because I'm crazy about her.
She's cute, isn't she?
She's the cutest thing we've ever had on this show. I said he tried to marry his ball.
Oh.
He was a desperate man. Yeah.
The chain would have been the, yes.
Gary,
here we go.
He's smart, isn't he?
Call on Susan. Albert said. I found the solution to the energy crisis, but it only works in Washington, D.C. I've invented an automobile that runs on blank.
Tapes.
On what?
Tapes.
On tapes. Did you hear what she said? She says,
that's funny.
But there's an 18-minute gap between Los Angeles and San Francisco.
That's right. Car only goes for 18 minutes. Huh? Yes. She said tapes. Dick, what did you say?
Well, I'm afraid I said something a little more prosaic. Hot air.
Hot air. And we're not kidding, senators. Brett, what do you say?
You know what I say?
Well,
let you and me get married.
You did it.
Hot air.
Hot air. Now, if you also said hot air, you got to think of something clever to say like they did before you say hot air and hold up your card, don't you?
I had something very clever, but it's too late now. You blew it for me. Hot air.
Hot air, okay. Hot air seems to have been the answer, Susan, although your answer of tapes is rather interesting. What do you say, madam?
I am so worried. I'm thinking like Brett now.
Really?
I said hot air.
Hot air. That's four orders of hot air. And now we come to Richard.
Tapes is a marvelous answer.
Yes.
No, really, because it, you know, would not only get you where you're going, it would lie about the mileage. I happen to hear all those politicians...
God, what is this, your third or fourth? Or second? Third.
Speak up, Evie!
This is your second day. Oh, well, you're a veteran.
No, it's...
Third.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Well, you're a veteran by now. It's his old hat, isn't it? Nothing to it, right?
Right.
Talkative rascal, isn't she? Now she's going to be challenged by Susan Copperthwaite, who will tell us a little bit about herself, if you would, please.
Okay, I'm married. I live in Simi Valley. I have two sons. And I enjoy needlepoint and growing plants, painting statuary. And I think you're terrific.
Thank you. Well, that's one for me. Mine. Needlepoint too.
Do you really?
Yes.
Isn't it fun?
Needlepoint is marvelous therapy. Yes. You see what it did for me? Now we'll start this game in a moment or so, but first we got this message for you. Here we go. Now, here we go. I will push this button, ladies, and reveal our two first round questions. Ask Susan to make a selection.
I'll take B, please.
B it is. Here we go. Everybody plays. New game, folks. Albert said.
Uh-huh.
I found the solution to the energy crisis, but it only works in Washington, D.C. I've invented an automobile that runs on blank. I found the solution. Think about that, Susan. I found a solution to the energy crisis. It only works in Washington, D.C. I've invented an automobile that runs on blank.
You know,
buddy. Oh, I got it. I got it, honey.
Yes,
you use it all the time.
Right. Look, and he was the first one for all right.
Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin. Brett Summers. Gary Burghoff. Marianne Mobley. Richard Dawson. And Patti Deutsch. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Ray.
What's wrong? Everything okay? Okay. We greet you. Don't overdo it. You'll get your check anyway.
Oh, okay.
Now, for those of the benefit of you in the studio audience and you who are watching maybe for the first time, have a little tradition. The celebrities always give a nice, warm greeting to the new kid on the block, and we welcome Dick Martin.
Yeah! Everyone, yeah.
How are you?
Just fine, Gene.
We're delighted to have you here.
You have a delightful show.
Thank you very much.
Have you ever seen it?
Yes. I wouldn't miss it.
Good for you.
Come on down.
He wouldn't miss it.
Okay, now let's say hello to our two players here, Evie Phineas and Susan Copperthwaite.
Yay!
Evie is our current champ. She's won one game, and she has $600 to her credit. And let's see, how many days have you been on now, Evie? I forget.